Hello, I'm Kayla, a 36-year-old woman. These past few months have been pretty draining, and so far I'm learning to do a lot of things all over again. I got into this situation thanks to my husband, Tom, but I was miraculously saved a lot more pain thanks to someone who was a good person and actively looked out for me. But first, let me introduce you to the people in this story. The first person I want to introduce you to is my sister, Maya. Now, Maya is 6 years younger than me, and she's a very pretty woman. Growing up, we struggled a lot to get along, mostly because I was your classic nerd and she was a popular diva. She always made it a point to pick on me and for some reason seemed jealous of me at all times. My mom tried her best to alleviate all the tensions between us, but that didn't really work. When I moved out for college, she didn't really talk much, but after I graduated and when she was in her teens, we began to talk once again. Well, our relationship got a bit better, but we weren't the closest still. That was the best our relationship was ever going to get, and I was okay with that. The next person I'll introduce you to is my ex-husband, Tom. We met through work and clicked very easily. We dated for around 3 years before deciding to get married. We worked hard and managed to buy our first house together, although since I was the one making more money, the mortgage and deed were in my name. After about 2 years of marriage, Tom asked me if we could have children. Honey, I was wondering about something and I need you to think about this with an open mind. All right, what is it? I've been thinking that we've been together for a while now and maybe we could start a little family of our own. Tom, you know how I feel about that. I know, but we have the money for it and it would be really cute for us to have a couple of mini-me's running around, don't you think? Yeah, but they're a lot of work and responsibility. We're the most hardworking and responsible people we know. Come on. Give me some time to think over it, okay? I promise I'll do everything to help take care of them. Just remember that, okay? Even though I wasn't keen on having kids, I gave in because Tom kept bringing it up for a year. We had a son first, and then 3 years later, we had our daughter. Initially, Tom was very helpful, but that quickly changed. Suddenly, I was responsible for taking care of everything at home, including the kids. After our first child, Tom insisted that I stop working because he had gotten the promotion which allowed him to earn more than me. I tried to fight him on it for the longest time, but I decided that it wasn't a hill I wanted to die on and made peace with my new life. Considering I would get pretty bored doing not much at home, I took to a new hobby, hosting dinners. I would invite my mom and sister a lot because they lived closer and my mother-in-law, Megan, whenever she was in town. Eventually, I began to feel comfortable in my new life. I got to spend a lot of time with my family, and that made me happy. Tom and I were doing okay. I had been going through some trauma after giving birth to our second child, where I almost died, so that did have some effect on our relationship. I didn't think anything else was wrong, but oh, how wrong I was. I was cleaning the house and my room to be more clear when I happened to come across a pair of panties that I knew were not mine. I felt my heart drop as I stared at the underwear. The only question running through my mind at that point was I not enough for him? I knew that I had been behaving differently, but I had just given birth to our second child, and sure, it had been over a year since that happened and I was still feeling the effects of the birth. I had been going to therapy for a while and I was making slow progress, but I didn't think it was enough progress because Tom was cheating on me. Once the shock wore off, all I felt was anger and betrayal. I needed to know who my husband was cheating on me with and why. I decided to first send Tom a picture of the underwear I found and asked him whose they were. Then I went through his laptop. I logged into his various social media accounts and went through his chats, At first, I didn't see any unknown women in the chats. That only made me more confused. I went through his messages as well and came up with nothing. In my desperation, I decided to go through every chat. At that time, I did think it was stupid of me to do that because everyone in his contacts was someone I knew. I didn't think that anyone in my life was actually capable of hurting me that much. That's when I realized that in every place that I looked, I saw my sister's contact ID first. That hadn't rung any alarm bells in my head at first because, come on, why would my sister's and my husband's talk raise any alarms? I decided to go through their chats. And that's when I felt the bile rise in my throat. The chats were full of pictures and videos of them in bed, of messages telling each other how much they loved each other and plans for Tom to leave me. I couldn't believe that my own sister would have been a part of something so horrible. We never had the best relationship growing up, but to do this? This was a whole new level of betrayal. The first thing I did was actually throw up because I was just so incredibly disgusted by both of them. The second thing I did was call Tom, but he didn't pick up. I called him a few times, but he didn't answer, so I called my sister, Maya. Hey, what's up? Don't hey what's up me. Jeez, what's got your panties in a twist? I don't know about mine, but I do know that I'm staring at a pair of yours in my bedroom right now. Oh? Have you been sleeping with Tom? Oh, yeah, for a while now. Why? Kay, come on, all of us know that you've gotten a bit boring. So you chose to sleep with my husband? Did the fact that I'm your sister not even stop you? Look in my eyes. I was doing you a favor. I was getting Tom off your back so you could focus on taking care of your kids. Are you okay in the head? That's the dumbest crap I've ever heard. Look, we didn't mean for it to spiral this far, okay? I only did it because he kept making advances at me and then... He's a lovely guy, Kay. Yes, but he was my husband. Why would you actively take part in destroying our family? I just want what's best for Tom, okay? If I'm the best for him, then so be it. You are a disgusting human being. I cut the call after that. I couldn't believe her audacity. I just laid in bed and cried for a long time. I didn't think my life would have ever come to that point. At some point, my youngest child woke up and began crying for food, so I busied myself with taking care of her. I felt like a shell of a human being as I carried on with the rest of my day. I couldn't let my kids know that something was severely wrong. That was not something for them to worry about. I picked up my oldest from school and made dinner for the three of us. The kids kept asking where their dad was, and I had no answer to give them. I lied and told them that he was working late. At some point, though, my anger morphed into concern. It was nearing 11 at night, and Tom hadn't gotten back home yet. I tried calling him multiple times again and got no response. I tried calling my sister to see if he was at least there with her, but he didn't pick up either. I had been so tired and drained from everything that day that I ended up just heading to bed. I desperately hoped that when I woke up, everything that happened that day would have been a bad dream. If that day was a bad dream, it only got worse the next morning. When I woke up, I immediately felt like something about the room was off. I looked around and realized that there was not a thing that belonged to Tom in the room. I hurriedly looked through the cupboards and drawers, and all his clothes and knickknacks were gone. I scoured the house and almost all his things except like really non-consequential or important things were gone. I couldn't believe it. Like a coward, Tom had just left me instead of even trying to communicate with me. He must have come back home very, very late at night while I was asleep and silently packed all his things up. I didn't know what to do or feel. All I knew was that my kids needed to be taken care of first, and then I'd deal with everything else. I woke up, bathed and fed my kids before dropping the oldest at school and then going to my mom's place with the youngest. My mom could tell something was up with me because I was being vacant. All that was going through my head was how I was going to possibly raise two kids on my own. Whenever I snapped back to reality, I realized that I also had to be the one who broke the news to my mother about my sister and husband. Eventually, my mom couldn't hold herself back anymore and asked me what was wrong. "Okay, I've put up with your weird silence for long enough. What's wrong?" I don't know how to tell you this. "Why don't you try and start from the beginning?" "Well, I found out that Tom has been cheating on me for a while now."
"What? What do you mean?"
"Yeah, I found a pair of underwear that wasn't mine and I texted him asking him whose it was. Well, he decided not to respond and instead just left me."
"Left you? What do you mean?"
"I woke up this morning and all his stuff was gone."
"Gone? What do you mean by gone? You didn't stop him?"
"I didn't even know when he came back home. I fell asleep at around 12 a.m. and when I woke up, the house didn't have anything of his in it."
"Oh my God. Oh my poor girl. I'm so sorry this happened to you."
"Yeah, well, it gets worse."
"Oh no, what is it?"
"Do you want to know who Tom cheated on me with?"
"You mean you know who he cheated on you with?"
"Oh yeah, I went snooping through his things to find out."
"I would never have accepted that behavior under usual circumstances, but this one's different."
"So who is it?"
"Maya." "Excuse me? What? Are you serious?"
"Yep. My husband has been cheating on me with my own sister. I called her to ask her about it and she seemed nonchalant about it. She just told me that they were in love with each other and she wanted what was best for him. She believed she was the best for him, so she was going to keep being with him."
"What in the world are you saying? Oh my God. What has Maya done?"
I don't even know how I'm going to survive. I have two kids to raise and I have to find a job too."
"Look, why don't you just get some rest while I process what you just told me. I'll be here to help you out, okay?"
"Yeah, okay. Thanks, Mom."
I had been numbed by everything that had happened, so it was relatively easier to tell my mom about everything. I ended up going to sleep while my mom took care of my youngest. When I woke up, I heard my baby crying and my mom yelling. I hurried out of the room to comfort my child and saw my mother on the phone. She looked mad. She hung up the phone a couple of seconds later and looked surprised to see me standing there. She apologized for the noise and didn't elaborate any further, but I knew that she had been giving Maya a piece of her mind. Over the next few days, Mom came to stay with us because it was easier to have one person move in than three. Maya kept trying to contact her mom, but she asked me to block Maya. It was really nice to have someone validate my emotions when all I felt was alone. I found out through a couple of mutual friends that Tom and Maya had gotten married. They reached out to me, concerned and confused. I had to humiliatingly explain things to them, but they were all thankfully comforting. All of them blocked both Tom and Maya and refused to associate with them. But from what I found out, both of them got married the day after Tom abandoned the kids and me. That stung like crazy to find out, but I mean, I shouldn't have not expected that from the both of them. When I told my mom about it, she was even more furious. If there's one thing you should know about my mom, it's that she's a very mild-tempered woman, and it generally takes a lot to get her angry, so it was really surprising to see her get so furious and upset with my sister. It was also great to have my mom's support financially. She was in no way obligated to help me out, but she really did do her best for the three of us. She helped me get a couple of job interviews too, because I really wanted to contribute to the family since Tom wasn't there to stop me anymore. Taking care of the kids was easy, but when they asked questions about Tom, I had to fight to not break down. Still, we made it through. A week had passed when I received a letter. The letter was sent from Tom, and I wanted nothing to do with it.
I thought that the letter was some type of apology, so I didn't want to read it. I was done with him, and a week was way too long to try and make amends, aside from the fact that he literally displayed the biggest act of cowardice I have ever seen by quietly running away from his family. So I did the next best thing I could think of. I burned the letter. However, after I burned the letter, I couldn't help but be curious about what was in it. Sometimes I would find myself wishing that I had at least read it before burning it, but then I'd come to my senses and remember that nothing he'd said would have changed my view of him and his actions, so I'd let it be. The next day, my mom and I had made plans to take the kids to the fair. We had a great time, and it was fun to be in a lively atmosphere after the bleak reality I had been living. I finally got to enjoy myself, and I laughed for the first time in what felt like a long time. My mom and I de-stressed that night over a bottle of wine where I told her about the letter. So, last night, something came in the mail for me. Oh? What was it? It was a letter from Tom. What? What did it say? I don't know. What do you mean? You opened it, right? No, I didn't want to deal with anything he had to say, so I burned the letter. You burned the letter? Kayla, what if they were official divorce papers? The envelope didn't look legal whatsoever. I know it wasn't that. Well, all right. If you say so, what do you think was in it? I don't know, maybe a half-hearted apology or even a request to return his last remaining things? I wouldn't put it past him to do that. But how are you feeling about this whole thing now? Well, today was definitely a good day. It's hard, especially when the kids keep asking me where their dad is. I mean, what do I even say? I guess it gets better as the days go by, but only marginally better. As long as it's getting better. I'm always going to be here for you, and just so you know, I'm working on disowning your sister. Everything I have will go to you and the kids. Oh, Mom, that means a lot to me. But are you sure you want to do that? Maya is still your daughter. I know you girls have had your differences growing up, but to do this when both of you are well into adulthood and be so unapologetic about it is unforgivable. I raised the both of you better than this, and Maya clearly did not care for it, so she's no longer my daughter. Obviously, I would have been upset if Mom's mind changed so easily when I asked her if I was sure. But I knew that Maya was still a baby that she had birthed. I mean, I could never imagine how hard it must have been for my mom to do that, because I could never imagine doing that to my kids. It only made me even more grateful to have someone so supportive of me with me. Another 3 days go by, and I get a knock on the door. That was strange, because I had not been expecting any guests, and aside from my mother, who was at work, there was no one who ever came over. I cautiously opened the door and saw two gentlemen standing in black suits. I only opened the door slightly, and I asked them who they were. They informed me that they were lawyers and had come over to deliver something to me. They handed me a note first and then a check. It was written out to me, and it was a whopping $750,000. My jaw fell to the floor when I saw the amount. I tried to tell the lawyers that there must have been a grave mistake, but they assured me there wasn't, and they urged me to read the note. The first lines on the note were, "Thank you for saving me." As the note carried on, I realized that this money was from my mother-in-law, Megan. In her letter, she went on to explain that she had been in town 3 days ago and stopped by our place to visit the four of us, but no one was home. She called Tom, and he tried to make a big show about entering the house, but his keys wouldn't work. I had the locks changed immediately after he had left. The letter continued with Megan explaining that she had felt something was off because Tom had been behaving weirdly, so she forced him to tell her what was wrong. He had admitted everything, and she was disgusted by his behavior. She explained that she felt bad for putting me through something so horrible, but she wanted to let me know that all her inheritance was going to me and her grandkids. She thanked me for saving her from making the wrong decisions and entrusting her son with all her assets. So that was what the check was for.
The lawyers then informed me that Megan had been terminally ill and had passed away just the previous day. She had expressed very clearly that she wanted me to have the money as soon as she died because she wanted her daughter-in-law and grandkids well looked after. Tears welled up in my eyes at the gratefulness and loss of Megan. Megan was truly an amazing woman who always stood for what was right. It was one of the many reasons that Tom had always felt so scared of her, yet I found her comforting. She truly had been a woman of her word and supported me until the very end of her life. A few days later, I got a call from Tom. I already knew what was going to happen, but I wanted to humor myself.
What did you do?
What do you mean?
You know what I mean.
Tom, you need to be clearer. What are you talking about?
Why weren't you at home that day? I specifically asked you to do that.
When did you ask me?
I sent you a letter asking you to just play along with our old selves while my mom visited for that day.
Oh, is that what the letter said?
Did you not read it?
No, I burned it before I could read it.
You robbed me.
My mother was going to make my life easier with the inheritance, but you stole it because you're a selfish person.
That's really rich coming from you. You abandoned your family and only contacted me when it involved your inheritance.
You can't stop love. I did what was right for me.
And your mother did what was right for us. Don't contact me or the kids ever again. Goodbye.
After that, things moved pretty quickly. I had served Tom with divorce papers, and I was also granted full custody of the kids. Tom tried to contest the inheritance, but Megan had made it explicitly clear that I was the one who was to receive it, so Tom did not win. Tom and Maya have tried to hound me and emotionally blackmail me into giving them the inheritance or a portion of it, but I have stood firm in saying no. Life has gotten significantly easier since we got the money. I set aside a good portion of it for my kids' college funds, and I invested a good portion of it as well. My mom has been able to retire while I have begun working. My kids have finally accepted that their dad won't be coming back, and when they're old enough, I plan on telling them everything. I'm still dealing with the pain of everything, but I know that there's only one way to go from here, and that's up.